I'm Jordan Rayner, and this is The Word Before Work. Today we're reading from 1 Peter 2, verse 9. Here's what it says. But you are a chosen people, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, God's special possession, that you may declare the praises of him who called you out of darkness into his wonderful light. Again, that was 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 9. Since Disney's Encanto was released just a few weeks ago, the movie has been played an admittedly embarrassing number of times inside the Rayner household. If you haven't seen the movie, no worries. Here's the quick gist of it. Encanto is the story of the Madrigal family who live in this enchanted house that magically blesses each member of the family with a unique and extraordinary talent. But as the family's matriarch frequently points out, the purpose of those gifts aren't just to serve the individual or even the family, they are meant to serve the broader community outside the family's magical home. You see it, right? This is essentially a story about spiritual gifts. And every single time I watch this beautiful film with my three young girls, I'm reminded of today's passage from 1 Peter 2, 9. Here's the connection. Prior to Christ, there were rooms in the temple devoted to storing gifts that the Israelites brought in. See Nehemiah chapter 10. The people would come into the temple, and the priest would distribute physical and spiritual blessings to them. But today, you yourselves are God's temple. See 1 Corinthians 3:16. And all of us are members of the royal priesthood, called to carry the gifts the Spirit has given us out into the world to be a blessing to the broader community. The gifts God has given us are not meant to be stored away. They are meant to be shared with the world. That truth, that perspective, should radically transform our perspective on the Great Resignation and the unprecedented rate at which people are quitting their jobs in the wake of this global pandemic. Now, to be sure, many people are handing in their resignations in order to focus on better opportunities. Others, especially lower wage workers, are leaving the workforce temporarily for reasonable concerns for their health on the job. But millions of people are not resigning for these reasons. Many are opting not to work at all or to take an early retirement. Believer, I pray that's not you. Our world is more broken than ever before. Businesses are struggling to survive, the poor are getting poorer, and every single day, thousands of people are dying separated from Christ. Now's not the time to call it quits and sit on the vocational gifts that God has given us. Now's the time to roll up our sleeves and use our gifts to make the world look more like the kingdom of God. Today's devotional only scratches the surface of how God's word connects to our work. If you want to go deeper, sign up for my free 20-day devotional called The Word Before Work Foundations at twbwfoundations.com. These email devotionals are designed to help you gain a rich understanding of the biblical narrative of work, how exactly your work matters for eternity, and what those truths mean for how we ought to work today. Sign up right now, again, totally free, at twbwfoundations.com.